Good morning, students. In this video, we'll discuss the chapter 4 of class 8 maths, that is cubes and cube roots. So this is the first video on this chapter. So let us discuss. So first is, what is a cube? The cube of a number raised to the power of 3. Okay, how it is? Suppose a cube of 3. I'll write a cube of 4. So 4 means 4 into 4 into 4. It can be written as 4 to the power cube. So it is called cube. Cube means power is 3. Okay. Next, we'll discuss what is called a perfect cube. Suppose a number n is a perfect cube. So a number is a perfect cube if it can be expressed as n equal to m to the power cube form for some natural number n. How it is? Suppose 27 is a perfect cube. So what are the factors are there? 27. So here you can write 3 into 3 into 3. So here n is 3 here. That is 3 into 3. 9, 9 is 27. It can be written as 3 to the power 3. That means 3 is n here and power is 3 here. So it can be written, what is n? N is 27 here. So what is perfect cube? A number n is a perfect cube if it can be expressed as n equal to m cube form, in this form. Okay? For some natural number m. So here it is a natural number, 3 is a natural number. Now let us discuss what is it? The cube of a, some facts about cubes. The cube of an even number is even. How? Let's take an even number. Suppose 2 is an even number. 2 to the power cube. It can be written as 2 into 2 into 2. So what is the answer? 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8. So it is also an even number. Next, see. The cube of an odd number. So let's see one odd number. Suppose 3 is an odd number and power of 3. So means cube of 3 equal to 3 into 3 into 3. What is the result? 3 3 is 9, 9 3 is 27. So 27 is an odd number. So we see that cube of even number is an even number, cube of odd number is an odd number. Now let us see another fact. The cube root of a number whose cube is n, it is denoted by in this form, cube root form. This symbol is used for cube root. What is the symbol? Root symbol, and here 3. You can write this is the cube root symbol. So what it is say that, what is the cube root? Suppose a cube root of 27, cube root of 27. So it is written as 3 in this form. It can be written, what are the factors are there? 3 into 3 into 3 cube root, that can be written as 3. Okay. Now the factors of cube are in triplets. Say that. See here. For example, 6 we can take here, 27. 27 is a cube here. Now, what are the factors of 27? 3 into 3 into 3. These are the factors of 27. So we see here that these are in triplets. So it is not in pairs, it is in triplets. So in square chapter, we see that the square is in pairs, but in cube chapter, we see that the factors are in triplet. Okay? Now we'll see that what is check for perfect cube. So now we'll check for perfect cube. You already know the perfect cube means it is a pair of, it is a triplets pair, triplets pair. Okay, that means the numbers are in 3. Okay, triplets. So the factors are in triplets. So here we are taking one number. I am taking one number 200. Let's check 200 and another number 864. So we'll check if these are numbers are perfect cube or not. Okay. So let's take 200. Find out the factors using prime factorization method. 2, 1 are 2, 0, 0. Then 2, 5 are 10, 0 here. 2, 25. Then 5. Okay. Now write the factors. So factors of 200 are 2 into 2 into 2. Into 5 into 5. What we see here? The number 2 is in triplet, but the number 5 is not in triplet. How? Only two numbers. If you multiply another 5 to this number, then it becomes perfect cube. So we will see that the number 200, so it is not a perfect perfect cube. This number is not a perfect cube. If we multiply which number? If we multiply another number 5, suppose 5 we multiply, so multiply 5, in this number we will get a perfect cube. So what is a perfect cube? We'll see it now. So here, if you multiply 5 to this number, that means 200 into 5, if you multiply, so which number will get? 1000. That means this number, 1020 are there? Yes. So 1000 is a perfect cube now. How? So 1000 is a perfect cube, means it is a power of 10. 10 cube. That means 10 into 10 into 10 is a perfect cube. 10 into 10 is 1000. Now let us take another number, that is 864. Let us find out by prime factorization method. So it is divisible by 2, because the digit is 4. 2 4 is 8, 2 3 is 6, 2 2 is 4. Now we are 2, 2 is 4, then 2 1 is 2, then 2 6 is 12. Now we can divide by 2, 2 1 is 2, 0 put here, 2 8 is 16. Then again division with 2, 2 5 is 10, 2 4 is 8, then 2, 2 is 4, 2 7 is 8. Now it is 27 now, 27 is not divisible with 2, it is divisible with 3. 3, 9 is 27, again 3, 3 is 9. So write down the factors. So factors of 864 equal to 2 into 2, how many table? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into 3, into 3, into 3. Now what we see here? The number 2, 1 triplet is there. Number 3, 1 triplet is there. But the number 2 again, it is not, another number is missing. For the triplet, another 2 is missing here. So what you multiply it? 864, so that we get a perfect cube. We'll multiply another 2, so that it will become a perfect cube. So it is not a perfect cube. It is not a perfect cube. So which one is perfect cube? If 864 multiplied with 2 multiplied by 2, we get a perfect cube. Okay, so in 864, if you multiply, because 2 is missing here for triplet, 864 into 2 will get a perfect cube. So 2 4 is 8, then 2 6 is 12, 1 carry, what is 61? 70. So we see here that the number 172, it is a perfect cube. Okay. Now let us discuss two questions. Look at the first question. It says that so that 729 is a perfect cube. So in the question it is already mentioned that it is a perfect cube, but we have to prove it. So let us for see that it is a perfect cube or not, for checking it is a perfect cube or not, we have to find the factors by using prime factorization method. So 729 is divisible by 3. Because 7 plus 2 is 9, 9 plus 9 is 18, give it 3, 3 2 is 6, and 3 6, then 12, 3 4 is 12, 3 3 is 9, then again 3, 3 8 is 24, 3 1 is 3, again 3, 3 2 is 6, 3 7 is, then 3 9 is, then 3 3 is. So write down the factors. The factors of 7 to 9 are 3, into 3, into 3, how many 3? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we see here that the number 3 are in triplets. That means it proves that it is a perfect cube. So it can be written as 3 for taking. So 7 to 9. This is the cube of 7 to 9. It will be 3 into 3. So 3 3 yeah? 9. Okay. So that means 9 cube is equal to 729. So 9 9 jar 81. 81 9 jar 9 jar 729. So that means to prove that 729 is a perfect cube of which number? 9. Okay. Now let us discuss another question. What is the smallest number by which 1323 should be multiplied so that the product is a perfect cube? So to prove this, we have to again find out using the prime factorization method. What are the factors of 1323? So let us divide with question. It is dividing it is with 3. 1 plus 3 is 4. 1 plus 2 is 6. 6 plus 3 is 9. Yes, it is divisible with 3. 3 4 is 12. Then again 3 4 is 12. And 3 1 is 3. Now again 4 4 is 8 plus 1 9. Yes, divisible with 3. 3 1 is 3. Then 4 minus 2 is 14. 3 4 is 12. 3 7 is 21. Now again check 3 or not. 4 and 5, 4, 7, yes, divisible with 3, 3, 2, jar, sorry, 3, 4, jar, 12, then 27, 3, 9, jar, 27, now 4 plus 9, it is 13, not divisible with 3, now take another number, that is, I think it is divisible with 7 now, 7, 7, jar, 49 now, 7, 7, jar, 49, so right, now 7 is a prime number, so it cannot be further divisible, so write down the factors of 1, 3, 2, 3. So what are the factors of 1, 3, 2, 3? Just write down 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 3, 3 are there into 7, into 7. So what we see here that these are in triplets. That and we see here that another 7 is missing here to make a perfect cube. So what the answer? Question says that what is the smallest number by which 1, 3, 2, 3 or 1,323 should be multiplied? So which number should be multiplied here? We see here that 7 should be multiplied. So write down the answer. So therefore 7 should be multiplied with which number? With 1323 to so that the product will be perfect cube. So that the product is a perfect cube. Okay. I hope you understand this concept of cube and cube roots. In the next video, again, we'll discuss some further questions about this chapter, cubes and cube roots. Thank you.